Hello friends, welcome back to NHSRN. Today we are going to see a new assessment station. It's called Pressure Area Assessment. Okay, it's an 8-minute station. Let's see how to prepare for that station. First of all, we can go through the assessment criteria. Let's see what are the assessment criteria. Okay. First thing, identify the most vulnerable areas of pressure risk. You can use the pressure risk areas name in a formal anatomical or plain English terminology. Both are accepted. Okay, so you can use either formal anatomical terminology or a plain English terminology, whatever. Both are accepted. Okay, first let's see what are the most vulnerable areas of pressure risk. Okay, first of all, heels, then sacrum, ischial tuberosities, another name is buttocks, elbows, temporal region of the skull, shoulders, femoral trochanters, hips, back of the head, toes, ears, and spine. Okay, to achieve full mark, the candidate needs to identify a minimum of 8 areas. For partial mark, a minimum of 5 areas. Okay, I hope you understood. At least you have to write 8 areas in your assessment station. The next important step is identifies signs that may indicate pressure ulcer development. Okay, so what are the signs of pressure ulcer development? Let's see. First one is persistent erythema, that is called flushing of the skin. Okay, the next one is non-blanching hyperemia, that means discoloration of the skin that does not change when pressed. Okay, that is non-blanching hyperemia. The next one is blisters. The next one is discoloration. The next one is localized heat, localized edema, localized induration. That means abnormal hardening. Okay, localized indurations, that means abnormal hardening. The next one is purplish or bluish localized areas. Okay, the next one is localized coldness if tissue death has occurred. Okay, then these are the major signs that indicate pressure ulcer development. Okay, I hope you understood. To achieve full mark, candidate need to identify a minimum of 7 areas. Okay, of partial mark, a minimum of 4 areas. So you must write at least 7 these signs in your assessment station. Okay, I hope you understood. So this is the first 2 steps you have to learn properly before you going to the exam.